Hello, my name is Jordan Passholders. I'm doing a visual analysis of the Park Bench Statesman. So here's a picture of it to begin with. I had originally picked this piece because of how much I disliked it starting last year. Here's a kind of a representation of when I first saw it. So as you can see, I was a bit shocked when I first saw the statue. I was expecting it to be something really cool, some big piece of artwork that I was like gonna enjoy every time I walked by it, and it ended up being some random man that I'd never, like, I had no idea who he was or anything, and I was like, and I thought it was completely dumb. So that's why I picked this piece of art. It's the one at the school that I felt the most strongly about, and it wasn't until this project that I really saw any significance in it at all. I decided to do some research and find out a bit more about Bernard Baruch. Maybe if I knew a bit about him, I'd see him through different eyes, and this work of art through different eyes. He began college at 14 years old, in which he studied economics and languages. Right after coming out of college, he went straight to Wall Street, and he began to amass his fortune. While amassing his fortune, he became a philanthropist. He was involved in quite a bit of charities, and he even established his own hospital. Soon, he was recognized by the government, in which he advised 6 different presidents. He advised Wilson, Hoover, Roosevelt, Truman, Eisenhower, and Kennedy. Under the presidency of Truman, America had harnessed the power of an atom. This was a great power that no other country in the entire world had. So the United Nations formulated a plan in a way to keep this power under control. Truman appointed Baruch as our representative for the United Nations, for the Atomic Energy Commission. Now when I look at this statue, I see so much more to it. What I find most interesting about the sculpture is that he's holding his own book, and I think it's a way of him questioning himself and just sitting there in thought. Also, the way he's positioned makes it look like he's waiting for someone to come and sit down beside him. There's quite a few sculptures that have Baruch sitting on a bench. He was known to wait in Lafayette Park and talk to random citizens that would come and sit by him. I even found another sculpture in Brook Green Gardens in Murrells Inlet, South Carolina, that looks almost exactly like the one that we have here at Anderson.
Excuse me, random stranger that I've never seen before in my life. Yes. What was your first thought when you saw this statue made last year?
Well, I thought it was a waste of money because the only thing this is good for is walking through. I mean, honestly, they could have used the money for this to build more parking spaces, better food. I didn't realize who the statue was until like literally 5 minutes ago when we started filming. And yeah, he's actually a very interesting, important person in our history. So one interesting fact that you may not know, Professor, is that I actually take care of a man who was good friends with Mr. Baruch here. And yeah, as a child growing up, he would, you know, kind of just mentor him. And I didn't realize that this was him until literally 5 minutes ago before the interview.